Assalamualaikum viewers, welcome to my channel Nikki's Cookbook. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to make a melting cone ice cream. Like it's an upside down cone. It gives the appearance of a melted ice cream cone and how to make this cake. I'm going to make it in strawberry flavor. Now for this, I have taken around 360 grams of premix. This is a vanilla premix. Into this goes 3 tablespoons of oil, refined oil, which does not have any kind of flavor. And then into this, I will be adding around 1/2 cup of water. You can check the consistency of your premix and add the water accordingly. This is the kind of a batter that we require. Now in a 7-inch mold, I have greased it and lined it up with a butter paper. Into this, I will be adding the prepared premix, and in a preheated oven, I will be baking this cake at 160 degrees Celsius for about 30 to 35 minutes till the toothpick inserted comes out completely clean. Now see, the cake is completely ready. Unmold it once it is cool. Now you can keep this in the fridge for at least 10 to 20 minutes till it cools down completely. And now what we're going to do is, after removing it from the refrigerator, we will cut down the sides of the cake. And then keep it aside in a vessel or in a bowl. Now I have taken 100 grams of cream cheese and around 300 ml of whipping cream, and I have whipped it till I get stiff peaks, and I have layered the cake into 3 slices. Now we'll start layering our cake. Now this is a cream cheese filling that I'm using. You can just use it with a simple whipping cream without any cream cheese, but cream cheese tastes very good with the strawberry filling. That's why I've used cream cheese here. Now you have to dab the sponge with some water. I'm using simple water here, and you need to wet the sponge and then the cream cheese filling, layer it with it and smoothen it out, and onto that top it with strawberry crush. You can use any flavor that you want. And then similarly, we will be layering the cake in a similar manner. First, we will be wetting the sponge and then layering it with the cream cheese filling. Just follow the way I have, completed the cake. I am actually filling up the gaps in the layers as well. Now, cover the whole cake with this cream cheese filling, and then you have to set it in the refrigerator for around 30 minutes. Now this is a crumb coated cake. I have covered it with the cheese cream filling. Now in the meantime, we are going to use the crumbs that we collected from the cake initially. Into this goes 1/2 cup of whipping cream, and then just make it into the shape of a ball. It becomes very easy with the whipping cream, and once the ball is made, just cover it up again with a layer of whipping cream. It need not be a very smooth filling. You can just dab it with some whipping cream also, and then keep it in the refrigerator. Now once the cake is out of the refrigerator after you've crumb coated it, now again we will put a layer of the whipping cream and the cheese, and then try to give it an even finish as much as you can. Try to give it a smooth. Now, once you have given it a smooth finish, I have just taken a comb effect. Now for this, I just rotate it along with the comb. And then I have taken 100 grams of dark chocolate here and around 50 ml of cream, and I have melted it on a double boiler. Now with a spoon, I'm just going to give it a drip effect at the edges of the cake. and then just place the ball onto the cake, remove it from the fridge and put it on the cake, and then just pour the chocolate ganache onto the ball and then on the cake as well. Now this will give it a melted cone effect because the chocolate is just dripping off from all the sides of the cake and even the ball. And now just place a cone onto this ball and this will definitely give it a melting cone effect. Now your melting cone cake is ready. This is a very delicious cake and it is just like a super easy recipe that you can just make at home and impress everybody around you. If you like this recipe, please do subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon for notifications, and until next time, goodbye.